Hello students, today we are going to learn another kind of a rectifier for full wave rectification, and that is a bridge rectifier. From the previous lessons we learned that how a half wave rectifier works and how a full wave rectifier works, but using a center tapped transformer. But then we understood that for constructing such a full wave rectifier, we require a center tapped transformer. Okay, so that is an inconvenience. So this is a more better way of constructing a bridge rectifier, and that is the bridge rectifier circuit. Here we require more number of diodes, but still there is an advantage of avoiding the center tapping of the transformer. So I'll show you the circuit diagram of the bridge rectifier, and this is the one. Okay, so as usual, we have an AC supply, and which is connected to the primary of the transformer, and from the secondary you will get the stepped down AC supply, or then this voltage is what we are giving to the rectifier circuit, and this part can be called as the rectifier circuit. Okay, so here we have four diodes, D1, D2, D3 and D4, and that is connected in a peculiar way. This is something like a bridge circuit or Wheatstone bridge circuit, which you might have studied in your plus two classes. Okay, and then you can see that here this diode D1 and D3, they are facing this junction A and B, with their negatives are facing the junction, and the other circuits, other diodes D2 and D4, they are facing its P side towards this particular junction. Okay, now it is very interesting to see the resistance connection of the resistance. In the previous half wave rectifier, we saw the resistance is connected just after the diode in a between this junction A and B. But then in the center tap transformer, we saw that the resistance was connected to the center tap. But here it is again different. The resistance here is connected between the junctions M and L. Okay, so this is how a bridge rectifier is constructed. Now in the coming coming slide, we will see how it works. Okay. Now consider the positive half cycle of the AC input. We have the AC input here, and consider the positive half cycle, which is shaded here. And the pink line here suggests actually the movement of the current, or the current flow direction is actually marked during the using this pink line. Now you consider that during the positive half cycle, we can say this part of the coil is positive and this part is negative, or you can say the maximum voltage across this is Vm. So that is, you can say this can be considered to be actually zero, and this is plus Vm, or Vm maximum. So you can say that the voltage across this secondary coil is actually maximum of the voltage across the secondary coil is Vm, which is the maximum of the voltage appearing across the secondary coil. We normally denote as Vm, and this is the voltage across it. Okay, now you see this is positive. So this positive, you just think about this point A here, and you can say that when this is connected to this is positive, this is positive. So basically the diode D1 is in the forward bias condition. Okay, now you again consider this is negative. So here negative, this point is also negative. Now you just think which diode will be forward biased here. Yeah, it is negative to negative. So that means the diode D2 is in the forward bias condition. But this diode D4, we know this is negative here, so D4 is reverse biased. You know this is positive here, so that then D3 is reverse biased condition. So here D1 and D2 are only in the forwards biased condition. Okay, so now we'll see how the current flows through this in the positive half cycle. So when the positive half cycle is positive, diode D1 is forward biased, so current easily flow like this through this. Now it comes here. Now will it pass through D4? No, because D4 is in the reverse biased condition. So it will not, current will not flow. So D4 will be an open circuit. This portion will remain as an open circuit. So current will not flow. So current will flow in this way, again through the resistance in this way. Okay, so by that time when it reaches here, we can say that D2 is in the forward bias condition. So naturally, the current will flow in this way. Okay, the current will flow in this way and finally completes the circuit. And the current flow direction is here shown in the pink line. You can see that the current flow like this, like this, like this, like this, then through the resistance, then again here, then through the diode D2, then here, then it again completes the flow. So here D1 and D2 are forward biased during the positive half cycle and the current flows through the resistance in this particular direction. Let me mark the direction. Through the resistance, the current flow in this direction. Okay. Now, so thus we understood how a diode or how the bridge rectifier works during the positive half cycle, and you will get the corresponding output in this way. Okay. Now you think about the negative half cycle. Okay. During the negative half cycle, that means this part of the AC is coming into picture. Okay. So at that time, we can say this across this coil, this part is negative and this is positive. So this is negative means, this negative means basically this will not conduct D1, only D3 is going to conduct. So this is positive means here we can say that the diode D4 will conduct but D2 will not conduct. So those diodes which were reverse biased during the positive half cycle will come in the forward biased mode in the negative half cycle. So here D3 and D4 are the circuits or the diodes which are conducting. So now I think about, start from this positive. Okay, here current flows from this direction, current flow from reaches here. So this D4 will be forward bias, so D4 current will flow like this, it will flow like this, again through the resistance it flow like this, flow it comes here. D2 is reverse bias, so D2 cannot be cannot allow the current to flow. So now it will flow in this particular direction. Okay, then in this direction, current, the circuit is now complete. So that is again marked in the pink line. You can see current flow like this through D4, then again through RL, and then again through here, then here. So again you can see that the current flows through the RL in the same direction. Current never changes its flow direction through the RL in positive or in the negative half cycle. In both the half cycles, current flowing through the resistance RL remains, the direction of the current remains the same, which means that you are getting a direct current at the output. So we said that this part we already explained in the previous slide. So next, in the negative half cycle also, you are going to get the same directional current along across the RL. So that is why we say that the alternating current got converted to direct current. But we know that you have to always keep in mind that the current is not exactly a single value output we are getting. Whatever oscillations are there in the input, that is reflected in the output also. But the reversal in the current direction will not take place at the output side. And that is why we say that the rectification has been done. Okay, or you have converted an AC to a DC. I hope you understood the working of the full wave bridge rectifier, both during the positive and during the negative half cycles. Okay, now we will think about, there are different ways of actually representing a bridge rectifier circuit. The connection is always the same, but then some people draw in some other way. So there are different ways of drawing a bridge rectifier. Now you see, this is another way. Circuit diagram, you had seen a resistance being drawn across these two junctions, right? Resistance was drawn between these two junctions. This is very similar to drawing a resistance. I am taking that portion. If you just take it out, take the resistance out and then keep it down, stretch it down. So it will be the same as this circuit, because say instead of drawing like this, I just drew like this, but then you remember there is no cutting between here. It is actually, this is not a cross connection. So okay, you have to take it out, then here resistance is connected. So again, if you observe that the resistance RL is connected between these two junctions, only thing is that you drew it outside the bridge circuit part, and the other thing, previous slide was, it was inside within that. but then it is only the change in the drawing, but then the circuit remains the same. So this is one way of drawing a bridge rectifier circuit. But here remember that I have not drawn the transformer, but practically we always put a transformer, but you can just to say the working of the rectifier, there is no the transformer is not a must, but here AC the signal is directly is given to the, it can be either the output of a transformer or anything, but then don't worry, you just to say the working, that is also enough. You know, it is not a must that you draw the transformer always. Then another way of drawing is, then you ground this part, you ground this part through a resistance. It is again the same. You join these two, right? You join this RL and you connect, you take a wire and then connect it to the ground. Then our resistance is also connected to the same point. This is also another way of drawing a bridge rectifier circuit. Okay. Then you have to derive the average values of voltage and average value of current, that is IDC and VDC for a bridge rectifier. That you can easily do because we have already done that for the center tapped rectifier. Exactly same, because output remains the same and the functioning also is the same, only the constructional part or the circuitry part only changed. So in that way, the derivation of the VDC and IDC is never going to change, or there is no change at all. So you can easily whatever is there, how you derive for the center tap rectifier, in the same way you can derive the VDC and IDC for bridge rectifier. That is your part, you have to do that. Okay, now just one more thing, that is about the peak inverse voltage of a diode. Now we know that now what a peak inverse voltage is. So peak inverse voltage is the maximum reverse voltage felt across a diode in the reverse biased condition. So that is the maximum voltage it can withstand. So above the voltage if you go, which means that if the rating of a rectifier or rating of a diode is above that PIV, it is safe. Because if the rating is below that value, for example, if you have 6 volt or 12 volt peak inverse voltage of a diode, and if you have a diode which has a PIV less than that, then it cannot withstand the peak inverse voltage. So the diode may go into the breakdown condition. So that is the maximum voltage across, maximum reverse voltage a diode can withstand, and that is what we call as the peak inverse voltage. So in a bridge rectifier, we can see what is the peak inverse voltage. In the half-wave rectifier, we found out that peak inverse voltage is the maximum voltage Vm. But then in the center-tapped full-wave rectifier, the peak inverse voltage of a diode was found to be twice Vm, because that twice maximum voltage rating should be there for the diode there. Now, what we'll see what that is in the case of a bridge rectifier. So this, we are talking peak inverse voltage, we are talking about a particular diode. We know that there are 4 diodes. Each of the diode will undergo the reverse biased mode also, right? They will have a forward biased mode as well as it will be having a reverse biased mode. So during the reverse bias, if what is the maximum inverse voltage a diode experiences, and that is what is known as the PIV. Okay, so you can consider any one of the diodes. So let it be in the in the positive half cycle. We know this diode D3 is in the reverse bias. Diode D3 in the reverse biased mode. So it means that this is positive, right? Okay, and this is negative. Okay, this is during the positive half cycle. So during the positive half cycle, we say that this is in the positive, and this is the negative. Okay. So we can say that the diode will not conduct. So that is in the reverse biased mode. So what is the maximum voltage? This is Vm. We can say this is Vm. Maximum voltage is across this diode is what? You just think, just to understand that, we can say this is positive. Okay. Now you just think about this is negative. So this is negative means this diode will be in the open circuit mode. That is, current easily flows through this diode, right? So current flows through this diode, and this will be in the negative situation, negative addition. And what is the negative value? So when a diode, we know that across the secondary of a transformer, the maximum voltage is actually the Vm, right? Maximum voltage is Vm. So that means if this is, we can say this is positive Vm and this is actually zero. If it has to be Vm, this is, we can say this is zero and this is positive Vm. Oh, so which means that this is Vm and this is zero. That is, it is negative compared to this positive polarity, or it is, we can say it is at the ground condition, or it is at the negative value. So the maximum voltage across a particular diode D3 is what is actually, it is the difference between these two, negative and positive, and that should be Vm only. So peak inverse voltage of a diode in a bridge rectifier is Vm. Okay, and that you can think in the same way we thought about the center tapped rectifier. There you understood that this negative was actually minus Vm. In the case of a center tapped bridge rectifier, this negative was actually minus Vm. But here this negative value represents actually the zero. So the difference across the reverse voltage, the difference of the reverse voltage or the potential difference, the negative potential difference existing between the across the diode D3 is actually equal to Vm. So peak inverse voltage of any diode in a bridge rectifier will be equal to Vm. The same thing you can also calculate using Kirchhoff's voltage relation. That I think that is more a mathematical way of doing it. Those who are really interested, you can do, or you can ask me. But then you can logically understand that the voltage appearing, negative voltage appearing across any diode in a bridge rectifier is actually Vm. Okay, so this is all about the peak inverse voltage of a diode in a bridge rectifier. Okay, so there it comes to an end. So now you try to understand in detail and then make prepared notes about this, and then you can comment or you can ask queries in the comment box. Thank you.